Hello dear learners, in today's video lecture we are going to talk about the beta-lactam antibiotic. From beta-lactam antibiotic we are going to talk about the candidate penicillin. Like penicillin is one of the member from beta-lactam antibiotic class, which is really very important from exam point of view. So in this today's video we are going to cover the general aspects of penicillin and in detail penicillin G, penicillin V and ampicillin, other penicillins we are going to cover. So to start with the penicillin general information, in today's video we are going to cover the content such as, first we are going to talk about the introduction of penicillins, then we are going to talk about the history of penicillin, how it discovered, Fleming found out the penicillin, then general structure and its uses and adverse effects. So to start with the history says that penicillin was discovered by the British scientist Alexander Fleming, which is the world's first antibiotic, discovered by Fleming in 1928 accidentally. That means when Fleming discovered the compound produced by the fungus, and he isolated that and he called it as, like, when fungus was identified, it was named as Penicillium notatum, and the isolated compound was named by the name penicillin. And he noted that whatever the fungus had grown on that bacterial plate had killed the surrounding bacteria also. So this all points Fleming observed, and from that further studies went on, and in 1945 Fleming, Flory and Chain received the Nobel Prize for the work of penicillin. It led to the synthesis and all other procedures development slowly. Continuing towards the history, Fleming, like you can see here in this petri dishes, this is the small growth of fungus which is bluish in color. So this growth in periphery, you can find that a clear zone is found. So Fleming accidentally left a dish of Staphylococcus bacteria uncovered for few days. Means that whatever the Staphylococcus, he left it uncovered, and when he found, when he observed that dish, when he returned back to the dish, he observed that dotted bacterial growth was there, but along with that dotted bacterial growth, a mold patch was also there which was growing, and that was Penicillium notatum. So the newly discovered active substance penicillin was effective even in the dilution of 800 times. That means up to 800 times also even the dilution was did, then also it was active. So these are few of the facts of penicillin discovery. Then next, if you will see, it is introduction. Penicillin, it is a group of antibiotic that are commonly used in the treatment of various infections like gram-positive, gram-negative bacterial infections, and these are known as, or these are categorized under beta-lactam antibiotics. Why? Because they contain the beta-lactam ring, and as you all know that it was derived from the penicillium mold. So in diagram you can see this is the penicillin mold fungus, and when they found that destroy the bacteria, and they led to the mechanism that they destroy the bacteria by inhibiting the enzyme, in bracket you can call it as transpeptidase enzyme, which is responsible for the formation of cell wall in the bacterial cell. So, by inhibiting the enzyme which is responsible for formation of cell wall, this penicillin will act. Next question, next thing is like structure. Now coming towards the next point, that is structure. As you can see here in the structure, this is the general structure of penicillins. In general structure of penicillins, as you can see here, there are two rings, and one ring is beta lactam ring, which is a four membered ring. As you can see, this is a square ring, and thiazolidine ring. Thiazolidine, matlab thia and aza. So this is five membered ring, which is thiazolidine ring, containing thia, that is sulfur, aza, that is nitrogen. So this is thiazolidine ring and this is beta lactam ring. Now the fused beta lactam and thiazolidine ring structure they have in their structure, like this is thiazolidine and this is beta lactam, both are fused, and a free carboxyl acid is present, as well as one or more substituted amino acid side chain is there. This is acyl side chain and free carboxylic acid structure. So these are few of the structural features of penicillin. This is the general structure of the penicillin, wherein you can find the acyl side chain. This is CH, NH. So when this R changes, the penicillin will change. Towards the structures like natural penicillins, just now we discussed that when this R will change, the structure will change. So you will find the similarity, like see here, till here it is CHNH, okay, CO, like they have written it like this, CHNHCO. Till this point everything is common, if you will see, and the rest all ring is also common, like this is thiazolidine ring, this is beta lactam ring, COOH group, CH3CH3. So this COOH group is there, which is free, and this is the beta lactam ring, and the substituents will vary in case of penicillin G and penicillin V, which are naturally obtained by the process of fermentation. So in case of penicillin V, if you will see the part which I have highlighted, if you will skip this part, the rest all structure is same. Even in penicillin G, if you will skip the highlighted part, nothing is different, structure is there. So only R will vary, like in penicillin V, since it is known as phenoxymethyl penicillin, it is phenyl oxy and this is methyl CH2, so it is phenyl methoxy. Now in case of penicillin G, it is benzyl penicillin, it is called as benzyl penicillin. So it is benzyl, means benzene ring and CH2. I have highlighted, and another remaining part you can see, it is same as that of penicillin. So this was about the few examples and the substitutions which are present on the penicillin general structure. Now there are, so here also after CONH it is CHNH2 benzene ring, so it is ampicillin. When it is CHNH2 benzene ring and hydroxy, it is amoxicillin. When it is CHCOOH and benzene ring, it is carbenicillin. So ampicillin is more than enough to remember. And if you will find oxacillin, cloxacillin, dicloxacillin, so the substituents are like this oxazole. I saw this one, isoxazole is there. So this cloxa is chlorine and dicloxa is 2-chlorine. So oxacillin, cloxacillin, dicloxacillin. Then now here different colored structures you will find. So the structure which is colored with this peach color, like this one, this one, this one, this one and this one, if you will find, this is nothing but the beta lactam structure. And the CONH is common. See this CONH, 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 COH, CONH. Only other examples like ampicillin, if you will see, at the ampicillin case, CH, NH2 and benzene ring. So till H2 and benzene ring. Azelocylline, carbenicilline and methicilline will be there. But because they are not in your syllabus, like diploma syllabus. But you can observe the structures, and those who have it in their syllabus, they can practice the structures. They have properly highlighted the R groups and common beta-lactam ring. Next part is, it is about uses of penicillins. In uses of penicillins, these are the general uses. It is not particular penicillin, like penicillin G, penicillin V. Overall uses, if you will see, there are five types, means what are the common uses of natural penicillins like penicillin G, penicillin V. What are the common uses of penicillin A is resistant penicillin, that means enzyme resistance penicillin, then amino penicillin, broad spectrum penicillin, and beta-lactamase combination penicillins. Now here, first to start with the natural penicillins, they can be used in various streptococcal infections. Infections caused due to streptococci. And then gram-positive rods. So gram-positive rods such as Clostridium, Actinomycetes, Lactobacilli, Mycobacterium species, okay, Corynebacterium, etc. Then meningococcal infections. In case of meningococcal infections, these are generally caused due to Neisseria meningitidis, which is nothing but the infection of membrane coverings of like which covers brain to spinal cord lining, like meningitis, and bloodstream infection, which is septicemia. Then it is also used in treatment of syphilis, which is a sexually transmitted disease. So it is caused due to Treponema pallidum, as well as prophylactic treatment of scarlet fever, that means preventive treatment for the scarlet fever, which is also known as scarlatina, caused due to Streptomyces pyogenes, which includes the symptoms as the name fever. It is a common symptom. It is rashes at the region of the neck, underarms, and the other parts of the elbow, knees, other parts such as elbows and knees. And penicillin resistant penicillins, if you will see, these are used against the staphylococcal as well as streptococcal infections. And amino penicillins are used in various conditions. First condition is otitis media. So it is inflammation of the middle ear, so which is caused due to virus or bacteria. Then bronchitis is nothing but inflammation of bronchi. Pneumonia, both are lower respiratory tract infections, so it is used in treatment of lower respiratory tract infections also. Then enterococcal endocarditis. In case of enterococcal endocarditis, which is caused due to a gram-positive bacteria, Enterococcus faecalis, which is a genitourinary tract infection. Then after that, it is also used in treatment of inflammation of meninges, meningitis, then urinary tract infection, bacterial endocarditis prophylaxis, that means preventive treatment for the bacterial endocarditis system. Then it is also used in treatment of Lyme disease and ehrlichiosis. Now Lyme disease is also known as Lyme borreliosis, since it is caused due to a Borrelia bacteria, which can be transmitted by the ticks. So it is a Lyme disease and ehrlichiosis. Now in ehrlichiosis, again it is a tick-borne infection, and this bacteria which is responsible for it is Anaplasma tachyae, and which is a obligatory intracellular parasite which infect and kill the WBCs. So ehrlichiosis is infection of WBCs, in short you can call, which spreads through the tick, or it is tick-borne bacterial infection. Then in case of broad spectrum, they are used like infections caused due to Pseudomonas aeruginosa. Then it is also used, since it is broad spectrum, it is used in treatment of mixed infections, then specifically urinary tract infection, and prostatitis, that is inflammation of prostate gland, then surgical prophylaxis, okay, treatment means preventive treatment. Then next thing is beta-lactamase combinations. Again, if you will see amoxicillin and clavulanic acid, ampicillin and salbactam, ticarcillin and clavulanic acid. So clavulanic acid and salbactam, these are beta-lactamase inhibitors, and amoxicillin, ampicillin, ticarcillin are the penicillins. So these combinations are used, like amoxicillin and clavulanic acid is used in otitis media, sinusitis, influenza, okay, skin and skin structure infections. So otitis media, we have already seen, it is the inflammation of middle ear which is caused due to either a virus or the bacteria. Sinusitis is also a viral infection, which is nothing but a swelling of tissue linings of the sinuses, and which otherwise would be filled with the air. Then next case is ampicillin plus salbactam combination. So this is used in skin and soft tissue infection, as well as intra-abdominal infections and gynecological infections. Then ticarcillin plus clavulanic acid is used in septicemia. Then lower respiratory tract infections. Now lower respiratory tract infections include infections like pneumonia, bronchitis, etc. Then bone and joint infections and urinary tract infection. So now this is a pictorial representations of penicillin's uses and side effects. So common uses, if you will see, like syphilis, gonorrhea, okay, urinary tract infection, then lower respiratory tract infections such as pneumonia, then septicemia, okay, meningitis, all these things, if you will see, it is used in treatment of these conditions. And the side effects, if you will see, they work as a static or sedal. It can have these adverse reactions, like GI distress is also there. Then oral or vaginal candidiasis is there, that is fungal infection. Generalized rash can be there. Anaphylaxis can be there, which is hypersensitivity reaction. So these are the side effects of the penicillin, common side effects. With this, we finish with few introductory part about the penicillin, which is nothing but beta-lactam antibiotic. In our next video, we will cover in detail about penicillin G, starting from the structure, properties, IUPAC, uses, official preparation, brand names, everything. So entire penicillin G note we are going to talk about. Thank you.